Once there was the sun, bright and warm and wonderful, shining like the love within my heart.
That's it.
On to the second page of the blueprints. As I had mentioned in a previous video, somewhere along the way, I did post these on my Instagram. They've had some modifications here and there, but mostly on the higher up floors, like the third floor and the fourth floor. Where am I going to start here? Let me start with the porch. So it should be 7, 2, 3. So this is what I've got now so far with the second floor. It really does end up looking like a maze, especially with all the quote-unquote hidden passages and hidden doorways that I like to have. Over here we've got the servants' quarters, which kind of leads out in this area, but then these two spots right along the center line on either side of that center line are both bedrooms with their own little baths. And then same thing over here. That little room, I'm honestly not sure what to do with it. I might end up taking it away just to open up the space. We'll see how it looks once it's built. But then, bedroom, bathroom, bathroom, bedroom. So, looking pretty good. Alright, and same thing with the first floor. Now I'm just gonna add in more walls and the windows and such. So, if it is just one block high, see that? It's technically leaking. As I'm filling in the extra layer that I, apparently need now, my brain is trying to come up with ideas of, oh, what if we had a step down to get out to the balcony? That would be so cool. And yeah, that would be cool, but for now, just to keep things simple, just, nope, we're gonna... We're just filling it in for now. Just for now, filling it in, and that's it. Please refrain from any other ideas. Thank you. Pretty sure this is not right. Because apparently this wall was not cut. It was in too much. Because you can see the line where it was two blocks off on this whole side of the building. So, had to fix that. But now it's like, this doesn't seem right. As you can see, everybody's got all the little rooms, all the little segments that each have a door. There's a door here, and there's two doors from the stairway leading up onto each side of this middle door. The idea being, again, going with the, again, I'm not sure if you would say, classical, but the more traditional housekeeping aesthetic. All the women are on one side, all the men are on the other. If you think of Downton Abbey, they have that perfectly set up, where there's even separate stairways in Downton Abbey to get to the women's side compared to the men's side. Completely separate staircases, It's like the living quarters in Hogwarts, At least in Gryffindor's tower, there's a separate stairway for the women and a separate stairway for the men, They are, however, connected, though, in case of emergencies, However, that door is locked, and it's only the head butler who's got a key, Now, I'm not worried about that. It's just the idea that there is a door there that blocks it off, but, women... and it doesn't really matter which side gets which, but women over on this side, men over on that side, and it's all good, that room and that room are all 3x3s, whereas the rest of them are all 2x3s. The idea being that those two rooms, one would be for the head male servant, and one is the head female servant, And again, they would only be going down, they would have no reason to get, to the second floor, really. They would have no reason to get directly to the second floor from their quarters. The servants that live in that section would all be like the kitchen staff and you know, and things like that. The bedrooms up on this floor, the idea with them is really just that they're kind of guest rooms in a way. And you'll see when I, you'll see the big difference. What the fuck happened here? Oh, right, that nameless room. You'll see the big difference between the rooms and the staff's quarters down here compared to the bedrooms and the staff's quarters on the third floor. And I'm still undecided, I may or may not add a balcony area on this half of the ballroom. Because as well, see, if you think of the, I mentioned in previous video as well, the Van Helsing movie starring Hugh Jackman. I can't quite remember off the top of my head if there were actually columns or if my memory is just placing them there, but there was definitely, it wasn't a balcony technically, but there was definitely an opening on the second floor level that overlooked the ballroom, you know? Alright, so here we go. Long story short, I kept messing up how thick the floor needed to be in order to compensate for the fact that there will be pools of water on the second floor, and to have it not leak through, how thick the floors have to be, and all that jazz. But here we go. Oh well, it's still good. I will make it work. I think the house is now one level of block higher than it absolutely needs to be now, but we're all good. The only thing that really got messed up was the servant stairs, because now it's, you know, clusterfuck at the top there, but I can modify that at some point. That's not a big deal. I'm sorry I have no better commentary. What should I talk about? Everybody, like all the cool kids talk about stuff, and I'm just over here like, nope, I'm gonna do this. Because this is what comes next. I talk about B-rated films, but I know there's some places that, some people that talk about that already. What's the one? She's funny, I like her. Oh god, what's it? Bad Movies and a Beat. She's awesome, you guys should check her out. She watches, she doesn't phrase it as, oh, I do this so you don't have to, you know, she doesn't phrase it like that. But she enjoys watching terrible movies. She enjoys watching B-rated films, you know, such as Velocipastor. She watched that, and she did a review video on it, and just how awful it is, and how badly it does not make any sense, you know? it's great. I need to look to see if she did, because there's a couple of films that I've come across that it's like, oh my fucking god, this is terrible. And like, I want to make recommendations for her, like, hey, have you seen this one yet? You know, but I don't want to be, you know, that ignorant asshole that just goes in and just, hey, you should do this. And it's like, I did last week. Watch my videos and you'll know, because, you know, when not everybody, you know, quote-unquote stalks the YouTubers that they watch, you know, not everybody does that. But still, it's like, before you go and leave comment after comment after comment saying, hey, do this one, do this one, do this one, have you ever thought about doing a YouTube search, you know, like, you know, their name, as well as, you know, using this as the example, you know, doing a search where it's just their name and the title of the movie to see if that comes up, because if it doesn't come up, then you can confidently, go ahead and send them a message saying, hey, you need to watch Werewolf versus Sharktopus. You need to watch Sharktopus and then watch Sharktopus versus Werewolf. You can leave them a comment that says, you need to watch Mennonite of the Living Dead. I need to look to see if she's already done these films, though. I kind of hope that she hasn't, because, oh my gosh. But yeah, speaking of Mennonite of the Living Dead, I want to finish Shark. I don't have Sharktopus. I can't find it anywhere. I want to watch it, though. But I have Sharktopus versus Werewolf, and it is exactly as it sounds. Sharktopus versus Werewolf. I tried so hard to watch it, and it got to a point where it's like, okay, cool, they should be just about done with the movie, you know? Like, they've, you know, Sharktopus and Werewolf are in, like, their fifth major fight with each other. This is the biggest one yet. This, you know, everything is pointing to the fact that this is the fight of the film. It's all gonna be good. It's all gonna be awesome. And, you know, and they've killed off the lead villain. You know, they've killed her off. So this should be the end, right? Right? Dude, I paused the film to see how much time was left, and I'm like, God fucking damn it, there's another 35 minutes. What the hell? How? We've been watching this movie for like 3 hours now, it feels like. At least I was able to get that far in it, though, because my housemate has a film, well, I don't know if Goku called a film or just a movie, but he's got a motion picture on file called There Are Monsters. And it's basically like the Napoleon Dynamite of horror films if Napoleon Dynamite had failed in the box office. It is so awful. So terrible. I made it through the first 15 minutes, I think? 10 to 20 minutes, I watched. And then I couldn't take it anymore. There Are Monsters. I'm so sorry. You guys tried so hard. I want to give it one more try to see if, you know, if I can, but I don't think I'll be able to. Mennonite of the Living Dead, however. That movie. Oh god, I have such mixed emotions about Mennonite of the Living Dead. Such mixed emotions. Mennonite of the Living Dead. The synopsis is that a satanic sex ritual went bad, and it woke up a dead Amish man, which right there is the biggest issue, because the synopsis says that he's Amish, but the title is Mennonite of the Living Dead, and maybe I'm feeling a little bit slightly offended because I'm slightly biased about this, but Mennonite and Amish, while very similar, are completely different things. Completely and entirely different. Very similar, but very different. And again, maybe I'm just, you know, it takes a lot to offend me, but that just kind of gets the, you know, the hair on my hackles raised, as it were. You know, I may be a little bit biased because I live in Amish country. I myself am not Amish, nor am I Mennonite, but I live in Amish country, you know. And yeah, the Amish and the Mennonite are very different. Very similar, but very different. And where I'm from, it's like, no, you fucking respect them. You respect everybody, but you respect them. And to refer to an Amish person as a Mennonite, or vice versa, like, why don't you ask what they are before just assuming? Because now you're being a jackass. Mennonite of the Living Dead. The synopsis. Yes, it's the satanic sex ritual goes wrong. It wakes up a vengeful Amish dead person. It's a dead Amish man who gets woken up. And it basically turns into like a Friday the 13th type of thing. The synopsis says that a whole group of these married couples get together, and they're all it says that they're all having marital problems, so they decide to do a weekend getaway thing of going to basically a cabin to have an orgy, because orgies fix everything apparently. And it, you know, but there's only one, possibly two couples that are actually married, and it's only the main character's marriage that is rocky. Everybody else seems totally fine for the most part, which doesn't make any sense. Regardless, satanic ritual goes wrong, and then the dead Amish man rises from the grave to put a stop to the orgy because it's assumedly offensive to him. I'm a dumbass. I'm running around trying to get to the servants' quarters. Here, my dumbass forgot that. No, that was kind of the point, that they were separate. You never had to encounter them. It's phrased something like that. It's phrased somehow that he basically just puts a stop to the orgy, you know. And so I started watching this. I got about the 10 minute mark, I realized, oh my gosh, this is golden. I've never found a movie that, before I even really got too deep into it, I realized this would be a great drinking game. But this movie is happening, so let me get this started before it gets too, no pun intended, before it gets too deep. That way, I can have the full experience, you know? And I'll be good. Well, that's right. So at the 10 minute mark, I broke out one of my shot glasses. You know, first time using it, yay! But broke out one of my Field of Screams shot glasses. Grabbed a bottle of red wine, because I don't have too much hard liquor, and I didn't feel like doing shots of hard liquor. And, you know, went at it. And I drank any time that something didn't make, any time there was a what the fuck moment, whether it was a hilarious what the fuck, oh my gosh, that doesn't make sense moment, or if it was a that's absolute shit. Whether it was the special effects or the writing, there were a lot of moments where it was like, okay, even I I myself don't know all the specifics of the Amish culture. However, I know that this part completely bogus. This part does not make sense. This part was confusing. This part was unclear. You know? Alright, enough of a break from that. This is what we have so far. Haha. I'm not gonna bother with decorating anything. Not quite yet. I really wanna get the building and everything put together. The third floor is where it starts to get a little bit trickier, because whereas with most other buildings, you know, they're done by the second floor, the third floor is purely just the attic. It looks like a freaking school building or prison, my god. You know, such as with this one, the first floor, second floor is the second floor, the third floor is just the attic space, you know? And I just filled it up with glowstone so it wouldn't have monster spawn in there, but it's just the attic space. Thank you so much for tuning in, my squidlies. Whoever you are, wherever you are you even there? As I think it was Julie wrote. But yeah, stay safe. Stay indoors, as you know. I don't know all the facts. I'm not a scientist. I'm not a doctor. From my understanding, and I don't want to, sound like I'm talking trash on something. From my knowledge, though, COVID-19, it's not, for the vast majority of us, it's not life or death. Literally, it is not life or death. Regardless if it is or not, though, just stay calm. Keep calm and carry on, you know, but stay calm. It's just a different strain of the regular flu, and there's no definite cure for it, but then again, there's no cure for the flu either, for the regular influenza flu. There's no regular cure for that. There's no cure for the common cold either. The issue is that they've been having trouble finding a good treatment for it. Now I have heard that there's a malaria drug that's been working real well. My housemate's co-worker's brother-in-law or something like that, friend of a friend type of story, got COVID-19. And he was on a respirator for, I believe he said it was 4 hours. They gave him the testing malaria drug, and I think he said that it was within an hour and a half the guy was being sent home. Treatment or not, though, you do what you gotta do. Do what you need to do to stay safe. Be patient. Be kind. You know. Don't be hateful. It's so easy to be hateful hateful towards people that are walking around wearing masks and gloves and such. It's so easy to be hateful towards them, you know, because they look ridiculous. They look absolutely ridiculous. It's so easy to make fun of people like that wear the masks outside and the gloves and everything. Especially if you don't believe it to be completely necessary. But be kind to them. Don't be jackasses. Because for all you know, they could, you know, the common cold could kill them, you know, and they need that mask because of this. And if it's not them, it's possible that they might be the ones that work at a nursing home or in a hospital, you know, where or they work at a daycare, or, you know, they babysit or something, where they are in direct contact with people that are greatly affected by it. Don't make fun of them. I mean, you know, make fun of them if you want to, but don't do it to their faces. Be nice, and most importantly, know when to stop. Know when to stop with the jokes. Not everything has to be funny. Not everything has to be a joke. As the sun is rising on this Minecraft day, have a good night.